Hi everyone, let's talk about the type union in TypeScript. Means a variable can have multiple types where you are not aware that okay, this type can be a null or can be a number, then put a union there. So let's talk about that. So I'm creating variable n1, which is of type either string or which can be either of type null or can be of undefined. Okay. And here math.random, actually I'm trying to just call this method which is of JavaScript. And what we are doing, if math.random is coming greater than 0.5, then assign undefined, otherwise it will be a test. Okay, you can skip null here, let's keep only undefined, but here you can also assign multiple variables. So here n1 is fine at runtime. If it is getting the value undefined or null, it is fine, because now we have decided that okay, this is of union type. N1 can be of type string and can be of type number, can be of type undefined, sorry. Similarly, even while declaring a variables, you can decide the types. So it can be of null also, or it can be of object, right? And here I'm assigning it something like this. Okay, n1 is, I cannot declare again, that's fine. Okay, so here it is fine. Either you n2 can be of an object or n2 can be of null. So initially at the earlier stage, if you're not aware, just assign it to null. Now from the application executions, n2 will be reassigned with something else. Then you will be assigning it with some object. Consider this is null, right? And here, n2 you are assigning to this. That is fine, right? But here, if you are putting it as a null and then again you are assigning that to the object, then it will be an issue, right? So you can see a type is not assignable to a null. But if I already had an agreement with TypeScript, okay, this is of, can be of an object, can be of null, then this will, compiler will be happy in this case. Okay, so here what we can do is with this particular code where we have n2 of undefined and null, we can just check it, n1 not equal to null. Here n1 can be of type either string or undefined, so we can just take care of our executions, whatever we wanted to do. n1, it is having a good feature, substring and 01. Okay, so these kind of checks you can put, because you already know that n2 cannot be null, that it means either it is undefined or either it is string. Okay, so here it's better that we can just put a check of undefined, not equal to undefined, then we can actually do the substring of that, right? Okay, coming to the next point is how we are declaring a type for a function, like whatever the argument you are passing or whatever the function is returning. We have seen that in the first video, but let's take a look on to that extent now. So if you wanted to pass some argument as an optional, then just pass it something like this string, and we are expecting that this function is not returning anything. Let's put a void, and now you can see if optional is equal to undefined, because you're not passing it, right? So in this case, you don't have optional parameter, so do a to do action, means whatever you wanted to do. Else, if you got the optional parameter, then do your action here, whatever you wanted to do, right? So here optional parameter is for sure a string, okay, because you are calling it. So consider it something like this. If I'm calling f1 and I passed undefined, okay, this will work, right? Because I made it as an optional and here this code will execute. But if I pass it as a string, in this case, this function will execute, and here I'm giving guarantee that you are getting a string. in the function argument and you can do whatever you want here. Okay, so this is how we do it. And if you wanted to return something, so we can also return undefined, right? If you are getting undefined, you can return the same argument. In this case, we are violating, right? So we are not returning void. In this case, we are returning undefined. So can we do the undefined and string here also? Okay, that's work. So here, you can also return the multiple union types. Either it will return the undefined or either it will return a string. Okay, so that's it in this video. In the coming video, take a look on more.